Charles Darwin believed that humans evolved from lower animals. He didn't believe they were created by God, and his incorrect beliefs about human origins led him to some troubling and extremely inaccurate assessments of human existence. You know, for instance, his evolutionary ideas led him to promote the sexist view that men are more evolved than and superior to women. In his monumental work, The Descent of Man, Darwin wrote, "The chief distinction in the intellectual powers of the two sexes is shown by man's attaining to a higher eminence in whatever he takes up than can woman, whether requiring deep thought, reason, or imagination, or merely the use of the senses and hands. The average of mental power in man must be above that of woman. Man has ultimately become superior to woman." You see, according to Darwin, males had evolved to a higher level than females. As evidence of his conclusion, he simply stated that males attain to a higher eminence in everything that they take up when compared to females. Using this line of reasoning, it would be impossible to condemn men for treating women as inferior, because if men have the mental or physical ability to treat women as inferior, it must mean that men are stronger or more fit to survive and rule. It's ironic that the atheistic community, which is so enamored with Darwin, is suggesting that the Bible's view of women is immoral. In reality, if their view of atheistic evolution is true, then all male-dominated societies are such because males are more able to dominate. And since survival of the fittest is desired, one must conclude that a male-dominated society in which women are viewed as inferior to men, as Darwin put it, must be at least one very prevalent, natural order of things. On the other hand, the Bible writers are often accused of being sexist and gender biased, but that is a completely false accusation. The Bible explains that God created both male and female in His own image. It explains that in Christ there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither male nor female. The Bible states that wisdom is one of the most important aspects of life, and then it illustrates wisdom as a woman who boldly instructs people in the way that they should live correctly in the book of Proverbs. When we look at Mary, she was given the monumental privilege of being the mother of Jesus. It's telling, is it not, that Darwin and his sexist views, based on the false idea that humans evolved from lower animals, somehow continues to dodge the criticism that he and his evolutionary ideas deserve.